It has not been all of tech suffering recently. Apple stock up 10% year to date and actually holding steady this week as well as the company gets set to report earnings after the close today. Market cap of the company sitting at $934 billion as we speak. Josh Lipton is in Cupertino with what we should expect from Apple this afternoon. Hey, Josh.
Mike, Apple is on a roll here. The stock is up nearly 15% over just the last 3 months. So here is what the street is looking for after the bell today. Earnings per share of $2.18 on revenue of $52.3 billion. Now, that would imply growth of about 15% on the top line. iPhone units, 42 million. That's up about 2% from a year ago. The iPhone's average selling price, $694, is what the street's looking for. That would be up 15% from a year ago. Analysts note that iPhone results actually matter less when it's this late in the cycle. So services, as always, in sharp focus, expected to jump 26% to $9.2 billion. RBC sees strong services momentum in the quarter, led, they say, by subscription growth and strong gaming specifically. And looking ahead, the street is looking for Apple to forecast Q4 revenue of $59.6 billion. That would imply a jump of 13%. Morgan Stanley sees slight downside risk to that forecast, though, saying their checks indicate that a 6.1-inch LCD phone, one of three new phones they're looking for this fall, could be delayed until October. Also, you're going to see a lot of attention on Apple's China business. Mainland China accounts for an estimated 15% of company sales. Some have expressed concern that as these trade tensions escalate, Apple could be collateral damage. Others counter, though, that Apple is in some way perhaps insulated here, that it sells a very popular phone in China, and assembling that phone, they say, employs millions of Chinese.